We built three camper vans completely from scratch.
And this one right behind us is by far our best work.
We're Ben and Katie from Two Wandering Souls. Again.
I forgot it was my turn. Here's like our... That is troubling.
Okay. Let's start this over.
Rewind.
We're Ben and Katie from Two Wandering Souls.
And in just a minute, we're going to bring you inside the van and show you all the fun features and secret things that we've added. But first, we want to take a minute to introduce ourselves and kind of explain how we got into van life, because it has been a journey.
Yeah, it has.
But before we hop inside, I need some caffeine. I don't know about
yes,
you.
Yes, please.
So let's go brew some coffee and sit down for a minute.
Sometimes it takes a lot of pressure.
Now that we've got our caffeination and our hydration,
we're ready to go.
Like we said, we're Katie and Ben from Two Wandering Souls, and I want to sip. And we're going to share just a bit about how we got into van life, because it has been something that has been part of our lives for the last 5-6 years.
Yeah, it's been a long time.
Yeah, six years. So back in 2016-17, we worked at a ski resort. And prior to this, for the previous 3 years, we had been traveling, teaching English in South Korea, basically just trying to explore and adventure as much as physically possible.
But then we came back to the United States and did a ski season up in Washington.
And after the season ended, we wanted to explore the US. We wanted to travel the West Coast, but there's a problem.
We were broke.
Straight up broke. Like, we had very little to our names. And so after a lot of thinking and talking to other people, we decided that the easiest, cheapest way for us to continue traveling would be to build a home on wheels. And so that's where we kind of got the idea of converting a van.
Our first van was, we bought it for $2,000.
You couldn't do that today. Like, it, yeah, times have changed.
It was a good deal. And then we converted it for about $1,000.
It was really basic.
Yeah, but we loved it. And we took that $3,000 all in and traveled around the Western United States for 3 months that summer.
And that van, I mean, everyone at this point names their vehicles, their camper vans. That van's name was Vinny. And Vinny was, like we said, very basic. There's no toilet. It was like
refrigerator.
It was a mattress that a friend had given to us, like squeezed in there. It was
very
basic, but we had so much fun and absolutely fell in love with the idea of bringing your home with you.
Yeah.
And so that kind of piqued our interest.
We found out that it was just like one of the best ways to travel, especially in the United States, and we wanted to do it more and more.
And so a few years later, we went abroad and we were traveling, and when we came back to the US, we knew that we wanted to build another van. This time we had a little larger budget to work with.
There you go.
Thank you, sir.
So we built our dream van.
Yeah, so all those years after Vinny, we had thought and dreamed up what would actually go into our dream van, and we made everything happen. We bought a larger vehicle, a tall roof, we added a refrigerator, we added a toilet. We thought it was just so plush and perfect for
that
us.
That van was named Pearl, and
she was a gem. I love that line.
He says that all the time, and it doesn't even make sense because a pearl is not a gem, but whatever.
Close.
So Pearl was great. There was a problem, though, because we found out that we were expecting a baby.
In 2021.
And so Pearl was a short wheelbase. There was no space to add room for another human.
Yeah, let alone a car seat.
So we ended up selling Pearl, saying goodbye to our dream van, and then we built Lola.
Welcome to Lola.
Yes. So first of all, I do want to say that one of our core beliefs is that van life can be for anyone on any budget at any stage of life. We in the past have lived in vans full time. This van is more of like an adventure vehicle for shorter trips or extended trips. So really, truly, if van life is interesting to you, you can do it. You can make it happen. We made it happen with very little money. And yeah, we just love, we have this passion for inspiring and encouraging and helping others create the van conversion of their dreams. And so on that note, we actually created a course called Van Conversion Academy. And it walks you through basically the fastest way to get a shell of a van converted to a home on wheels. And so if you're interested, if you want some help along the way, check that out. We'll drop that link below. Yeah.
It literally is the fastest way from zero to 100 of getting on the road and traveling in your camper van.
Also, if you're interested, we have van tours of Vinny and of Pearl. So if you're interested in checking those out, seeing how those vans compared to this one, do that after watching. Watch this video first.
Yes, don't watch this one first. And then head over to the
Yeah. Okay, without any further ado.
I think we're ready to tour this van.
Yeah, I think it's time to show you around, so.
Let's do it. Was that too much excitement?
So awkward.
Was that way too much?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Too much caffeine for Ben. Well, maybe that's a good one. So fun fact, we actually filmed this entire van tour last October, I think it was. We were on the East Coast. We were at this beautiful campsite, like surrounded by colorful leaves. Spent the whole day filming this tour. And then, I don't know, like we had trips, the holidays, like things got, like life happened, and we just never published that video. And so we decided to refilm it, but let's just take a second and plop in some B-roll so you can see how pretty it was with all the fall colors.
So we're gonna start this tour on the exterior of the vehicle, and I'll show you everything on the outside, which is also known as the exterior. So this van is a Ram ProMaster 3500. It's the extended version so that we have a little bit extra space on the outside. When we bought this, it was completely brand new. It was just a shell of a vehicle. So everything that you see is what we have added to the vehicle itself, including these two windows on the side and two on the back. Well, actually I added another one on the back because about a week before we were about to complete the build, the neighbor kid threw a basketball into the window. I had to take it all out. It was crumbling all over the floor and I had to replace it. That was a super stressful time, by the way. So yeah, I've added five windows. You can only see four right now. There's also this runner, which is super nice when trying to get into the vehicle, that you can actually step up and get into it. Otherwise, this is for a ProMaster, they have a very large step. And when you're carrying a baby in and out of a vehicle, you wanna have a smaller step. It makes life a lot easier. And then on top of the vehicle, I built a custom roof rack so that it can hold our six solar panels. So we have 600 watts of solar on the roof. We also have a max air fan for circulation. And I also installed the Wii Boost, which is our cell signal booster. It works okay. It's not the greatest thing. It's not gonna create cell signal out of thin air. We're actually really curious about Starlink. If you've tried out Starlink yourself, leave a comment below and we'd love to chat about that. But that's basically all the modifications that we've made to the outside of the vehicle. So let's head on inside. And I think I'm gonna let Katie start that tour.
How do I look?
Gorgeous.
All right, let's head inside. I know this is the part that you've been waiting for. All right, so the first thing I want to point out is right here we have some sneaky shoe storage. So one thing that we knew that we really wanted to prioritize in this van was a place to put our shoes immediately when we came inside. There's nothing worse than having like dirty, muddy, cakey, sandy, gross, nasty shoes on your floor getting everything dirty. So definitely don't forget about shoe storage. This storage actually extends over here, and in this section is just stuff that we don't need to access all that often. Another thing you definitely shouldn't forget in your van is a little mini dustpan and broom, and just like a spot, a sneaky spot to hide that, which for us under these seats is perfect. you'll notice right away that we have this two seat bench seat right here, and this is the section for our daughter Juniper. You might be wondering, okay, they created this van, they built it specifically because they were having a baby, so where's the baby? Well, today she's at daycare, and the reason for that is she's at a stage where she loves running around and roaming about. So if we were to have filmed this video with her here, it would have been a very different video, let me say that. So anyway, we're about to take off on a road trip in just a couple days to Canada, and we'll definitely be putting in some clips of Juniper in the van so you can see how this space actually works with a toddler. So instead of just putting a single seat back here, we would have had more space, but we decided that in the future, if we do want to have another child, we don't want to have to reconfigure things. So we just put in a two seat bench seat just in case, you know, future proofing. And no, family, friends, we do not have any plans right now. I'm just saying for the future. Okay, so behind her car seat, you'll notice this piece right here. This actually folds out of the wall and it becomes a crib.
This is how the crib folds down. There's two latches up here and then one hook down below. And it kind of swings out to a flat space. And this corner hooks up to that eye hole. So this is actually a really strong and flat surface for her to lay on top. Next, we put in some of the railings. And then close the curtain. Then we have this foldable pack and play mattress that is perfect for this area. This is actually how we kind of designed this space based off of this size of mattress. And this railing goes in right here. Nice and strong and sturdy.
This crib was amazing and worked really, really well until Juniper was about a year old. Then she started getting a little too big for it. And so we had to get, and by we, I mean Ben. Ben had to get really creative and come up with a new concept for a bed. So right now, this whole area actually converts into a toddler bed. This whole section is kind of Juniper's up in here. It's kind of empty right now because, again, we're just about to head out on a road trip.
Is that an elf on the shelf?
Elf in there. But yeah, this is her space. Let's bring you up into this cab area. Right above my head, the bulkhead is where we store a lot of like our camping gear. We also really like hiking and backpacking, so that's where all of that goes. And then these seats do swivel around, so we can kind of all hang out in this area if we want to.
One nice thing that we put in are these blackout curtains. When we do go to sleep, it completely blacks out all the cab light, so.
Okay, now come back into the cab with me. It's a typical cab. Yeah.
There's not much to say about it.
There's a little turtle and a rock. So back here. Ooh, bathroom or kitchen? Which one first?
Let's go kitchen.
Kitchen. Okay, so you'll see this is a very uniquely shaped kitchen. Originally when we made it, this extended out like this and we had about this much space to walk. I told Ben there's no way I'm gonna like shimmy through. So got creative again.
My bad.
It worked perfectly and I kind of love the shape. You'll notice right here, these bungee cords. This is kind of like our pantry. We put like dry goods in here and it's nicely, like easily accessible and it fits a ton. So we have this section, and right now, again, it's pretty empty. But like I said, in a couple days, we're gonna be stocking this up and heading out on the road. So let's do a little editing magic. We'll start empty. In this section is our gray water tank. Ooh, that looks kind of gross. Did we not empty that?
There's a little water in there.
Yeah, gross. Well, gray water is just gross in general. So this is a 5 gallon, 6 gallon?
About 5 or 6 gallons.
Tank. So we just empty that when we need to. And right here is our sink. Oh, somebody didn't clean out the sink.
Oops.
Yeah, gross. Okay, so we've got this faucet running water, obviously, hot and cold water. And right here is filtered water. So we have nice filtered drinking water no matter where we're filling up. Another kind of fun feature
is we can swivel this around, and if we need to like rinse off like feet or something like that, we can do that outside.
Or just juniper in general.
Toddler life. Got some fun little decor that we picked up on some of our travels. One thing I kind of wanted to point out, and it's these little guys, they're like, they don't look like they would work. It's like a sticky-ish thing. It's removable, it's washable. These things do not come off. Well, okay, this one does because this is Velcro. We used to use Velcro, but I actually like those sticky things better. So, yeah.
Hot tip. Is there a spice rack?
Oh, yeah. Ben built me this custom-made spice rack. One thing I will point out is we were using like Trader Joe's spice bottles at the time, and so he kind of like built it to accommodate those. And now, like, if I get other spices, they don't quite fit, but it's pretty great.
It's custom for Trader Joe's. Trader Joe's, you're watching, it's for you.
So we also have a 2-burner gas cooktop. We really like cooking, and so we wanted to make sure that we had a pretty spacious kitchen. You'll see we have, for a camper van, this is actually like quite a bit of counter space. Right here in this like awkward space between the fridge and the stove, we put a silverware drawer, and all of our drawers are soft close, which is so nice.
Which is super nice because they stay closed while driving then.
Yeah. Our last van, we had some issues with that. Up here, we actually do have real tile. One thing to point out about this is we talked to some tile experts, and we also have tile in our shower. They suggested making sure that we use flexible grout. So grout that has it accommodates for movement. So that's one thing that I wanted to point out. And we have had tile in this van and our last van and no issues. We've got this magnetic rack for our knives, a little divider between the kitchen and the bed area, which I really like. And then one of my favorite things is this refrigerator. In our last van, we really compromised on our refrigerator. It just took so much energy. This is the isotherm.
I think it's like 65 liters.
It is very expensive. I'm not gonna lie, it's expensive, but I love it so much. It has a freezer. It uses very little energy comparatively, and it works amazing. Yeah, so right behind this French press are the lights. Well, you can't really see it because it's light out, but they turn off and on, and they're on a dimmer, which is like highly, highly, highly recommend using a dimmer in your camper van, because at night you really don't want to have bright fluorescent lights. You want to be able to like adjust that a bit.
Are there any other lights like on the floor?
Yeah. This is actually super nice at night, because if Juniper's sleeping, we can turn this light on and still be able to see everything in here, and it doesn't wake her up, it doesn't blind us. This light is,
and it looks super cool.
And it's also on a dimmer. And then in here is our bathroom. This is what it looks like when the door is shut. And then what's this one called? Nautilus. This is like the Nautilus door. That's kind of like what all people have, because it works really well for van life. They have really great customer service as well. We had kind of an issue and they were great. So once again, we have actual real tiles in here. Using that flexible grout, they've held up really well, and I really love having real tiles. We have our composting toilet. This is the Nature's Head. We have an entire video that goes through the Nature's Head, so if you're curious, if you're looking into toilets, be sure to check that out, because we go into all the pros, all the cons, and I'm not going to get into it here other than to say that we love it. This is the second Nature's Head that we've purchased. Wasn't a believer at first. Before we bought our first one, I was like very skeptical, and now I'm obsessed. Here is a nice little rack for like our shampoo. We keep toilet paper up there sometimes. All right, let's head to the back of the van 2 steps backwards. So you'll notice that there's this step up, and I perfectly fit here. Ben does not.
It's custom made.
So this step is actually some sneaky, sneaky storage.
Sneaky, sneaky, sir. Right this way.
This is where we keep like board games, jackets, bulky things. So right here, we've got a nice little vanity area, kind of, is what we call it. Up in here is our control panel. All of the That is messy. We've got some board games in there too, apparently. Yeah. We've got lights, light switches, and outlets so we can charge our phones at night. And then we've got this little fan here, which in addition to the max air fan and this bunk window that slides open and has a bug screen, we actually get really good airflow in here. Over here, we got more drawers. I let that soft close. Let me do that again. Okay. And then these two super narrow cupboard, door, closets, whatever they're called.
This ended up being a little inconvenience at first, but then we made it into a positive.
Yeah, so this one right here is meant to be a wine rack. However, right now it's empty. Let's do a little editing magic again. So this wine rack, there's kind of a funny story behind it. When Ben was designing it, he used a bottle of wine that we had at home and kind of like, you know, used that for measurements. Turns out that that particular bottle of wine was very narrow, like abnormally narrow. And so this wine rack doesn't fit most bottles of wine. So like when we go to the store and we're looking for wine, we have to be like, ooh, that's a skinny bottle, like thumbs up. For more mistakes that we've made in our van, with our three different builds, we've definitely made a lot of mistakes. We actually have an entire video dedicated to all of the mistakes that we've made in our van builds. So go check that out if you're curious. So that covers this one. Over here is where we store this little chunk of wood, which is this is part of our bed, and we'll show you how it fits, but this is just like a really awkward thing to like have, so this is a nice storage spot for it. It also is a storage spot for some of our window coverings. One mistake that we made with our first van, Vinny, remember the super budget build, was we did not have very good covers for our windows. And at night, people could see in, essentially. So we decided with our next van, we were gonna make blackout covers for our windows. So I made these. You can buy similar things, but they're very expensive. And I figured out, it took me a lot of trial and error, but I did come up with these like pretty perfect magnetic insulated window covers. So you just snap them on. They're totally blackout. They help insulate and so like keep it cool or keep it warm, whichever temperature we want. And they look really pretty. So anyway, this is our window cover storage cupboard.
If I wanted to build or make a cover like that for myself, where would I go?
If you're interested in making them yourself, like I said, you can purchase them. There are a lot of companies that sell similar products. Like I said, they're pretty expensive. When we were kind of like pricing it out for this van, it was gonna be in the range of like $600 to $700. I made these for about, I think it was like $130. So if you're curious and if you too want to make your own insulated magnetic window covers, I actually created a tutorial. I'll share the link below so that you can head to that tutorial and check it out for yourself. Okay, so another thing is our table. So this is the Lagoon Swivel, and it's pretty sweet. We had one of these in our last camper van and we really liked it. It truly like does a great job of moving the table however you want to move it. I'm very proud of this beautiful table I made. But anyway, when we want to convert this seating area into a bed, this table comes off of the mount and it sits on these rails right down here. And then along with that random piece of wood I showed you earlier, they create a platform for these cushions to like come together like a puzzle, and it becomes a bed. And these cushions are super comfortable.
What are they made out of?
They are made out of a memory foam mattress, which we cut. I actually have a tutorial of how to do that. We've got all the tutorials, guys. So if you're curious about building your own van, be sure to check out all of our content. We've got free content. We also have our Van Conversion Academy course. And you know, we're gonna just show you a video of how we set up this bed so that you don't have to listen to me and like try to picture it. We'll just show you how it works.
But I first wanna shout out Katie because she designed this and made this whole entire table.
Aw, thanks.
Which is pretty cool. So now we're gonna take it off and make our bed. the extra leaf that goes next to the table to extend her bed.
Another one of my like fun projects. Just a little fun wall hanging to add some color in here. And then up here, that is our projector. So let me show you how that works.
Okay, so at night, if we want to watch TV or something while Juniper is sleeping, we have a curtain that kind of separates our space, but we like to set up our bed and then we pull this down. This is actually just a blind. And this becomes a screen for our projector. So we also will connect it to our earbuds so that we don't disturb Juniper. But if you don't have a child with you, like really don't have to do that. But this is such a nice little feature to this van that we love. Okay, let's talk about this seating area because this is where we spend a lot of our time in the van. In our last build, Pearl, we had a really similar type of setup and we really loved being able to have a really comfortable space to hang out even if we didn't want to go outside, like if it was raining or we're parked in a city or something like that. So this is where we eat a lot of our meals, we play games, we hang out with Juniper. And so I love how spacious and comfortable it is. Oh, up here, this is kind of like our closet. And again, let's do some magic. So this is where we keep our clothes and it might not look like a lot of space. It's really not. However, using packing cubes, we can actually get quite a bit in here. One of them is for me and one is for Ben. And sometimes I put some of my extra clothes in Ben's.
Definitely do.
One other thing to point out is Ben just added these struts like 2 days ago and they are a game changer because for the last year, I've been like using my head to keep the thing up while I get my clothes. So this is so nice. So thank you, Ben, for finally getting those struts up.
I'm sorry it took so long.
What else? Okay, so underneath these benches, there's a lot going on. There's the water and the electric systems that I want him to explain. All right, Ben, let's hear it.
So like Katie said, there's a lot going on underneath these benches and I'm going to show you one by one. So underneath this side is the electrical compartment and then underneath this side is the water system. I'm going to start with the electrical side, but first I need to kind of get some of these things out of the way.
Okay.
Getting old. So as you can see underneath the mattress, we have these wooden slats. Whenever you're building a platform for your mattress, you want to make sure that your mattress can breathe. Also, it allows for our electrical department, sorry, electrical system, electrical department, to have a little bit of airflow too, so that it doesn't just
overheat.
Have stagnant air. Yeah. So as we open this up, so this is our complete electrical system and I'm all self-taught when it comes to electrical stuff. So I'm pretty proud of what I've created here. It looks like there's a lot going on here, which there is, but once you break it down component by component, it makes it a lot simpler.
Okay, so we're agreed we're gonna be pretty simple here.
Pretty simple. I can go really in depth, but I'll try to keep it as concise as possible.
Yeah.
If you want to go really in depth, I have a whole electrical blueprint and an electrical workshop. Hello? Hey, Siri. So Siri's interested.
Okay, so the first time we filmed this, Ben got real nerdy. But
I turned on my nerd glasses and I was like, hey, look at all these components here.
And yeah, this time around, let's keep it simple, okay?
Short and sweet. But if you want to go in depth into how this electrical system is set up, actually I have a whole blueprint and a whole workshop for an online course set up at Van Conversion Academy.
So you can see every single component, how they're connected, all that good stuff.
And how to connect them yourself too. So the simple version is there's power coming in, there's power being stored, and then there's power going out. We have two ways, we actually have three ways of power coming in. One would be through shore power, where you'll actually plug in your van to like a household outlet
or a campsite.
Or
but
a campsite.
We never do that.
Yeah, we never really have to do that because we have so much solar power, which is another way of power coming in. We have 600 watts of solar power coming into our solar charge controller, which then goes into our batteries to be stored. Or another way that we can get power is from our engine battery. So once our engine battery is topped off from the alternator switches and starts charging our camper van batteries. So those are the three ways that we can charge our camper van batteries. Our camper van batteries then are these five lithium ion batteries from Battleborn.
Ben's obsessed.
They're so great. We have the capacity to go days on end with just being completely off the grid. Batteries in an oil van, there are AGM batteries, which are great, but you could only go down to 50% capacity because if you go below that, then they start deteriorating over time. With lithium iron batteries, they do not do that. And these Battleborn batteries, they actually have a heated component too, so that when we go below freezing temperatures, they stay warm and so they continue functioning. They are more expensive, but over the lifetime of your camper van, they're gonna be worth it because you can go from 100% capacity all the way down to zero. I think it's recommended about 20% to as the minimum, but they are awesome and I cannot recommend them more. So now that we talked about power coming in and power being stored in the batteries, with this whole electrical setup, we are able to power everything in this van. So everything that you see from the lights to the fan to the water pumps, that can all be powered from this electrical setup. We can even set up our like household outlets, regular 120 volt outlets, through our 3000 watt Victron inverter.
So that would be like a water boiler,
our water kettle, our actual water our water heater for the entire system of our water,
our laptops.
Yep. So basically everything in the van is powered by this electrical system.
All right, well, Ben is getting the other bench seat uncovered so he can show you the water system. I wanted to mention that up here underneath the bench seats, we actually have a diesel heater that we installed so that we can keep the van nice and warm at night when we are camping in temperatures where it's chilly. So last year we took a fall foliage road trip in New England. Highly recommend that as a bucket list trip, by the way. And at night when it was chilly, we would just flip a switch, turn that heater on, and this space would heat up in literally minutes. It was
so nice.
Especially being that we were traveling with a baby, we wanted to make sure that she was comfortable and safe sleeping at night.
So underneath this bench is our whole entire water system. It looks like a lot going on, but it's actually pretty simple.
Just like you said, for the electric system.
Come on now. Okay. So basically we have this water tank right here. It's our fresh water tank. It can hold 30 gallons of water. And from our water tank, it goes through a pump and an accumulator. And then it can go from that pump. We have pipes leading to our shower and to our sink, as well as a little sprayer out the back. We also have a water heater, not a hot water heater, because why would you heat up hot water?
That's a little inside joke. Ben always says hot water heater and I make fun of him for it.
So we have a electric water heater back here that heats up the water really quickly.
In our last van, we had a propane
water heater, which you had to have a little bit more ventilation for a propane water heater because it lets off CO2, I think.
Yeah, we had to like always take our mattress off of the thing when we wanted to shower. It was kind of a hassle. It took a while to heat up.
An electric water heater is much more simple.
Especially now that we have a bigger electric system.
Exactly. So we have our hot and cold lines leading to the sink and to the shower.
Which one's the hot line? Which one's the cold line?
The red is the hot, the blue is the cold. But I want to take you all back to show you what I think is the most special feature of this van is our recirculating water system. So Katie gave me this challenge when I was creating the shower and the whole water system that she wanted to have an endless shower, endless hot water shower, instead of these like military showers where you turn it on and turn it off.
Is anyone else with me on this?
I mean, it is really nice to have that.
You know, I'm trying to get out of the shower sooner and then I ask myself why? I mean, this is where I want to be.
So I got to thinking, okay, we need to have a recirculating water system. Water that actually just cleans itself and then you can continuously use that water for the entirety of your shower without turning it on and off.
And without wasting gallons.
Exactly. So I came up with a system that I think was pretty cool and I want to show you it. So So basically, if you come on over here, from our water tank, water goes into the water heater and into the shower. And from the shower, it drains into a gray tank, which is actually underneath the van. But with a few flicks of the switch in our control center, I can make it drain into our recirculated water tank. It gets pumped out and it goes through a series of—
Ooh, yeah, you've got this on a slider.
Four filters. The first filter is a spin down and then it goes through a series of three other filters, a UV light filter to eliminate any bacteria, and then it goes back into the shower. This recirculating water system allows us to take 5 gallons of water and circulate for a continuous hot water shower for as long as we want.
So one thing to note here is that after doing a lot of research and like watching videos of other people who had recirculating systems, what everyone kind of seemed to say was that if you used soap, even biodegradable stuff like Dr. Bronner's, in the recirculating system, you would start to notice the water getting kind of slimy. And so people just said, well, we just shower without soap or shampoo. And so then I said, Ben.
This was the real challenge that she gave me.
Yeah. I said, Ben, can you make a recirculating system? Whoa, that bee got,
We're getting attacked by bees.
Yeah. Okay. So I said to Ben, could we make a recirculating system that can switch on and off while in the shower? So basically, I can take a nice, long, luxurious hot shower and then tell Ben, hey, turn off the recirculation, and then I can wash my hair, rinse it off, and that water will go into our gray tank. Then I can turn it back on the recirculating and continue my long, endless hot shower. So essentially, this is the best of both worlds. We can shower with soap and shampoo, but we can also have a very long extended shower. The only limitation is really how long our daughter allows us to shower for.
That's very
true.
Uh-oh. Hello.
Honey, it's sleepy time.
And with the recirculating shower, we're able to use the same water for at least like 3 or 4 showers each.
At least. And oh, yeah, each. Yeah. So that's like 6 to 8 showers.
Like 6 to 8 showers. And we typically just dump that water and then refill it because we naturally refill our whole water system at that time.
Yeah, we'll need to like fill up so that we have water for drinking and cooking. It's luxury at its finest.
Boy, this is living, huh?
Yeah.
If you want more information about how I created this recirculating shower, please write down in the comments below and
give him some motivation, because I've been telling him to do this for like the last year and he needs some motivation from you.
Thank you.
So in our last van, we did not have an indoor bathroom. We had a shower just like this and it worked pretty well. However, it was just difficult to find places where we could shower. We would have to get way out in the wilderness. A lot of times our feet would get all muddy when we're doing it, because I mean, like, look at the ground. Like other times if we were at a campground, we would feel really weird doing it with people around us.
We
did have a shower curtain, but it still just was difficult to find places where it really worked to take a shower. So we decided with this van build that we wanted to step it up a bit and have an indoor shower. But at the last minute, Ben was like, I want an outdoor sprayer as well, just to like get dirty feet after a hike.
Comes in handy.
Rinse off the toddler, all that kind of stuff. So it is kind of a nice feature.
An angle.
All right, we hope you enjoyed this van tour. Thank you for sticking along with our goofiness along the way. I am obsessed with this van. I love all of the thought that we've put into it, mm-hmm. and it works so well for this stage of our life.
And this van really has been years in the making, with building other vans and improving it and then improving it again.
And we're super excited to take her out on yet another adventure this week.
So if you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe to our channel. That really helps us out.
And if you have any questions about anything having to do with this van, the layout, be sure to comment below and we will do our best to get back to you. Thank you so much for your time and for coming along on this tour with us.
Bye bye for now.
Bye bye.
How do you end this video? Until next time.
Should we just do this whole thing one more time?
Sure. Okay, start over.
Not the most polished at making YouTube videos. Thank you so much for coming along on this. Maybe our first time was fine.
I think it was.
Okay, let's be done. Bye!